Okay dear students, today in this class you are going to learn about exercise 3.1 on data handling. Okay, let us see now. Exercise problem: find the range of heights of any 10 students of your class. Okay, first I will put tabular columns. Okay, three columns I will put: SL number and name of the students and height in, okay, height in feet, right? Let us see now. Okay dear students, I have made here tabular column, right? SL number and name of the students and height in feet. Okay, because here we need to find out here range, find the range of the heights of 10, any 10 students of your class they have told. Okay, you can take any names. Okay, for example, first one I will take here Puneet. Okay, Shivaraj, Prashant. Okay, and I will take Manjunath. Okay, next I will take here Satish. Okay, and Ajay. Okay, and remaining students Rahul. Okay, Ayush, and our remaining two you can tell that one. Okay, Sadik. Okay, and Muhammad Farooq. Okay, I have taken here 10 students name. Okay, height in meter we can take any height. Okay, for example here Puneet height is 4.2. okay, this is according to for 7th standard class, right? 4.2, 4.5, okay, and 5 and 5.1, okay, 5.3 and 5.2, right? And 5. See, again I will take 5.1, right? Okay, I will take here 4.8. okay, I will take here again 4.9 and 4.5, right? Okay, we need to find out your range. In earlier class already we have discussed about what is the meaning of range, right? Highest score minus lowest score, or highest observation divided, okay, highest observation minus lowest observation, right? Let us see now. Range, range is equal to H minus L, highest observation minus lowest observation, which is equal to, see in this, which is the highest observation here? 4.2, 4.5, 5.1, 5.3 is an IS, right? 5.3 minus, see here, lowest, which one we have to take here? 4.2 is there, 4.5 is there, 5, 5.1, all 5, 4.8, 4.9, 4.5, see here, 4.2, okay, which is equal to your 5.3 minus 4.2, right? 3 minus 2 is 1 point you can take, okay, 5 minus 4 is 1, therefore range is 1.1 feet, understand? Okay dear students, here we have second question. Organize the following marks in a class assessment in a tabular column first. Okay, that they are given here following marks. Okay, we need to find out here which number is the highest and which number is the lowest. Okay, and what is the range of the data, and find the arithmetic mean. Okay, very simple. First I will arrange those numbers. Dear students, in this, which is an highest here? 4, 6, 7, 5, 3, 5, 6, 2, 5, 1, 9, 6, 5, 8, 4, 6, 7. Is it right? Here 9 is an highest. Therefore, here organizing following marks is 9. Right? Let us see now. Okay, I make here 4 columns, right? SL number and marks, tally marks and frequency, right? Let us see now. Marks total, how many are there here? Observations? 9 observations, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 are there. Okay, we have to make tally now, right? See here, total here, first one, marks is 1. Okay, marks is 1. How many are there in this? See here, marks is 1. Only 1 is there, right? We have to put in first column. Okay, I will put here first, that is tally marks, like this. Okay, next, second one you see, 2. Here 2, how many are there? 1. Only 1 is there, 2 also, right? Sorry, here 2, here 1 is there, here 1 is there. Total how many are there? 2 are there, right? So, tally mark is 2. We have to put like this, right? Okay, let us see now. Third one, where will be there? 3. 3, 1. Okay, 3 is only 1, right? Put tally marks, that is like this, 1. Okay, next, 4, 1, 2, 3. How many are there here? 3 are there, 4. 4, how many are there? 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, next, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? 5 total highest number like this, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to put here 5 cross like this. Got it? Okay, let us see now. Next, 6. 6, how many are there? Let us see now. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Total how many are there? 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Okay, next. And next is 7. 7, 1, 2. How many are there? 7 here. 2 are there. So we have to put here 2. Okay. And next, 8. 8, how many are there? Let us see now here. 6, 5, 1, 9, 6, 5. 8. Only 1 is there. So we have to put here. We have to put tally mark like this. Got it? Okay. Next, 9 is. Okay, 9. Last number. 9, how many are there? Let us see now. See, 9 is also only 1 is there, right? So we have to put here. Like this, tally marks, okay? Let us see now, frequency. Frequency here 1 is there, so write 1. Here 2 are there, right? Here frequency 2, okay? Number of frequency, okay? Let us see now, 2. Here 1 is there, right? Here 1. And 3 is there, right? Here 3. And here 5 is there, right? Here 5. And 4 is tally marks, right? 4. 2 is there, right? 2. 1 is there, 1. Okay? And here also 1 is there, 1. Okay? Let us see now. Now, according to questions, we have to understand here which number is the highest and which number is the lowest, okay? And what is the range of the data? Find the arithmetic mean, okay? See here, which number is the highest, okay? Which number is the highest here? 9 number is the highest, right? Okay, which number is the lowest, which number is the lowest in this year? That is 1, okay? 1. Okay, and second one, what is the range of the data? Range is equal to highest minus lowest, right? Okay, after that is find the arithmetic mean. How will you find here? Sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Look at range is equal to, first one, what is the question? Which is the highest number? Okay, that is, I will write here answer 9. Okay, second one, which is the highest, which is the lowest number? That is 1, right? This is the highest. 9 is highest and this is lowest. Okay? And third one answer, what will be there here? Third one question is, range of the data. Range is equal to H minus L, right? Here H minus L means highest score is 9, right? Highest score is 9. And the lowest score is 1. Okay. H minus L. 9 minus 1, which is equal to 8. Range is 8. 8 is the right answer for range. Okay. Next. In this fourth question. Fourth question, what will be there here? That is, find the arithmetic mean, right? Arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is equal to sum of all observations plus what will be there in marks? Sum of all marks divided by number of marks. Okay. See here, number of marks total how many are there here? 9 are there, right? Total 9 are there. So, sum of all marks means we need to see here, marks is there here column. Okay. Take the marks column and we have to add all those. Okay. 1. See here. Total how many are there? 1. 1 are there. Okay. Very simple here. Okay. Sum of all observations. Right. That is. Okay. We have to. Okay. Shall I keep here? Okay. Sum of all observations. 4 plus 6 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4. Plus 2, okay, 4, 6, 7, 5, 3, 5 3 5 na, that is 4 plus 6 7 is 4 6 7 5. Okay, I have taken here 5 and 4, so plus 2 also I have taken, so plus 3 I will add. Okay, plus 3. See, up to 2 how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 happened, right? And the remaining, which one we have missed in this? 4 6 7 5. Okay, one more 5 will be there in this. Plus 5 I will add. Okay, plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 5 plus 1 plus 9. Okay, and plus 6 plus 5, 6 plus 5 plus 8 plus 4 plus 6 plus 7, right? Okay, let us see now, total how many are there here, divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 are there, right? Let us, you know, we should add all those numbers, right? Okay, okay. And number of marks, how many are there? 20, just we, okay, counted, right? See, number of, even number of frequency, if we add, means we will get 20. Let us see now, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 5, 12, 12 plus 4, 16 plus 2 18 18 plus 2 20, right? See, even number of observations also, how much we will get here? 20 we got, right? We can write here 20. Therefore, for this solution having, I will write this side. Okay, here arithmetic mean, that is mean is equal to, if we add we will get here, okay, 4 plus 6, 10, okay, 10 plus 7, 17, 17 plus 5, 22, okay, after adding we will get here 100, right, divided by, how much is there here, 20, 0, 0 will get cancelled, okay, and 2 ones are, 2 fives are, therefore, arithmetic mean is 5, okay, this is the right answer. Okay, dear students, here we have third question, find the mean of the first 5 whole numbers. See, we have solution, that is question number 3. Okay, see here, what are the first 5 whole numbers are? 0. See, whole numbers should start from 0, okay, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, total how many we have to take here? 5 whole numbers, right? The first 5 whole numbers are... 4 numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Okay. Let us see now. We need to find out here mean. Okay. Simple. We have to take formula. Arithmetic mean or mean. Okay. Mean is equal to same formula. That is sum of all observations divided by number of observations. We have to take this formula. Okay. Sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Okay, very simple. Sum of means 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 divided by how many are the total? 5. Number of observations or number of frequency also we can call, which is equal to 1 plus 2 3, 3 plus 3 6, 6 plus 4 10 divided by 5. 5 1 jar 5, 5 2 jar 10. Therefore, right answer is 2. Okay, mean is equal to arithmetic mean or mean. Mean is equal to 2. Okay, dear students, look at the fourth question. We have a cricket scores of cricket scores the following runs in 8 innings, right? See here, they are given here. Cricket scores 58, 76, 40, 35, 46, 45, 0, 100. Okay, we need to find out here mean score. Okay, this one you have to do at home. Okay, let us see now. See, what is the formula of here arithmetic mean here? Mean score, which is equal to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Total how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations are this. Is it? Number of frequency or number of observations are 8 are there, right? We should add all those divided by 8. Okay, do at home. Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about the fifth question. See here, following table shows the points of each player scored in 4 games. Right, how many games? 4 games. See here, player A, total player 3 are there, and games how many are there? 4 are there. Okay, let us see now. Player A, that is game 1 14, and game 2 is 16, game 3 is 10, and game 4 is 10. Okay, those are points shown in the table, shown in the table, right? And B points are, B player points are game 1 0 and game 2 8 and game 3 6 and game 4 4. Okay, and player C also, game 1 is 8, game 2 is 11 and game 3 he did not play. Okay, therefore and even we can take here 1 2 3. Okay, we can take 3 or plus 4. Okay, or 4, because 4 means did not play here one, right, one game, so we have to take here 3 and a half. Okay, 1, 2, 3. That is the number of scores. Okay, and game 4 is 13. See here, now answer the following questions. First question we have, find the mean to determine A's average number of points scored per game. Okay, we need to find out here mean, right? Okay, second question we have, to find the mean number of points per game for C. Okay, this is also we need to find out here mean. And would you divide the total number of by 3 or 4? This has given C. Just I told na, 1, 2, 3 you can take, or you can take 4. If you take 4, same total only it will come, right? See here. And third question we have, B played in all 4 games, how would you find the mean? See here also we need to find out mean. Okay, and fourth question, who is the best performer? This is very important, right? See, we need to find out A, B, C means. After that we will get the who is the best performer. Okay, let us see now. See here, by looking this table, A is an, I think, best performer, right? See here, 14 plus 16, 30, 30 plus 10, 10 plus 10, that is 50 are there. Here, see, very less are the remaining, right? So, we will get, I think, A only best performer. Okay, now solution we have. Solution. See, and first one is, that is mean of a player, right? Mean of solution. Solution, this is question number 5, right? Okay, mean of A player. Okay, mean of player A is equal to, we have to take here sum of scores by A. Sum of scores by A divided by number of games. Number of games played by A, right? Let us see now. Sum of scores by A, what are the scores here given? That is 14 plus 16 plus 10 plus 10, right? Divided by sum of games played by A, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Which is equal to, that is already we have counted, that is 50 divided by 4, right? Okay. Let us see now. This one we will get 4 1 ja 4, 4 1 ja 4, 4 2 ja 8, 0.45 ja 20. We will get answer is 12.5. This is mean of A. Okay. This is A player's mean. Right. Okay. Now, second one. Okay. Second one. What is the second question already we read? Okay, that is B played in all the four games. Sorry, second question is to find the mean number of points per game. Okay, for C, right? And also, would you divide the total number of, that is 3 or 4, already have told, right? Okay, and second one we have. Okay, let us see now. And also here, B player, what he done? He played only, okay, he played 4 games. Okay, let us see now. Mean we will find. Mean of B player, okay, mean of B player is equal to sum of scores by B divided by, because the last finally last question what will be there, who is the best performer, that's why we have to find out here mean, right? Sum of scores by B divided by number of games. I think second question is, that is C performer they are told, right? That is C is here, no? So I have to take here C. I have done here mean B. So this one, what I will do means, I will do here 3. Okay, I will write here 3. Mean of B player, sum of scores by B and number of games. Okay, and here sum of scores by B, what are those? That is 0 plus 8 plus and 6 plus 4, right? Divided by 4, which is equal to 8 plus 6, 14, 14 plus 4, that is 18 divided by 4, 4 1 ja 4, and 4 4 ja 16, right? 4 4 ja 16, point again here remaining is 40, and 4 9 ja 36, again we will get same, right? So what will be this answer here? 4 4 is 16, point remaining is 2, therefore 4 5 is 20 is equal to 4.5. mean of B player is, that is 4.5, okay, 4.5. now third one completed. Second one we have not done, right? Second one I will do now. Okay, second one question is, because third question already we done, that is B played in all the four games, now how would you find the mean? That is third one. Okay, second one, to find the mean number of points per game for C, I will take now C, right? Okay, here seed one, we would divide the total number of 3, because player C played only how many games here? 3 games, right? Because third game is not played, did not play. Okay, third one, mean of player, mean C of player is equal to, this is also formula, that is sum of scores by C divided by number of games, okay, number of games played by C only, okay, is equal to sum of scores by C. What is the C scores? That is 8 plus 11 plus, and third one is did not play, so no need to write plus, direct I will take here 13, fourth one, game 4, okay, divided by total how many? 4 here, okay, because he did not play, we have to take here 3 or 4, already he has told. So here only 3 are there, third game is did not play, na, so we no need to take, we can take it as 3 or 4 they have told, so I will take here 3 only, okay. 8 plus 11 is 19 20 21 22, that is 32 divided by 3, right? Okay, what will you get? Let us see now. 3 1 ja 3, okay, and again 3 1 ja 3, okay, and remaining is 2, therefore this one we can write it as, we have to take here 0 after point 2 will be there, so I will take 3 6 ja 18, 3 6 ja 18 means remaining how much? Again 3 7 ja, it will come 32 divided by 3, 1 ja 3, we have to take, so 0, here also 0, 3 6 ja 18, okay, 3 6 ja 18, again, the point I have taken here, 10.6, okay, 3 6 ja 18, again we will get 2 here, again 6, right, 10.66 we will get, right, 10 point, mean, C is equal to 10.66, okay, let us see now. Fourth question we have, who is the best performer, right? Okay, look at this. Mean A player 12.5, and mean B is 4.5, okay, and second one, that is mean C is 10.66, right? Therefore fourth question, who is the best performer, now you have to tell, right? See, comparing means of all players, player A is the best performer. Player A is the best performer. Right, this is the right answer. Okay, students, now let us discuss about sixth question we have, right? Okay, sixth question. The marks out of 100 obtained by a group of students in a science test are 85, 75, 96, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 95, 81, and 75. Find the first question, we have highest and lowest marks obtained by the students, and second question, range of the marks obtained, and third question, mean marks obtained by the group. Okay, just we discussed, right? Okay, same like this only now. Okay, look at here first question, highest and lowest. See here 85, 76. In this highest is 95, right? And lowest is 85, 76, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 81, 74. That is 39, right? 39 is the lowest. So range, how will you find here? Here, okay, range of the marks, and range is equal to highest minus lowest. Then only you will get your answer, right? And mean marks obtained by the group means that is sum of all observations divided by number of observations. We have to apply that formula. Okay, look at now. Solution. This is question number 6, right? Okay. And first one, that is highest is, first question, highest is, that is 95, and lowest is, that is 39, right? Okay. And second question in that, what is the second question? Range we need to find out. Is it total how many questions? Three questions are there. Okay. Range is equal to, that is H minus L, highest minus lowest, is equal to 95 minus 39, which is equal to here 15 minus 9, which is equal to here I will write 4. Okay. And sorry, 6, na? That is. That is 6. Okay. Because 9 plus 6, which is equal to 15. So, right. Okay, one carry here. So, 9 minus 4, which is equal to 5. Therefore, range is 56. Right? And third question we have, that is mean, right? Mean of obtained marks in a science test, right? That is mean is equal to, that is, I will take here sum of all observations, now sum of marks. Sum of all marks divided by number of marks. Okay, number of marks. Okay, look at now. Mean is equal to sum of marks. We should add all those, right? That is 85 plus 50, 76 plus 90 plus 85. Plus, okay, 39 plus, okay, 48 plus 56 plus 95 plus 81 plus 75, okay, divided by, that is the number of observations total, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are there, divided by 10. Okay, mean is equal to, yes, sum of all observations, we should add all those. See, after adding, we will get here 730, okay? You know how to add, okay? Addition, you know, 730 divided by 10, 0, 0 will get cancelled. Therefore, mean is equal to 73 is right answer, okay? Mean is equal to 73, and this is right answer. Okay, now let us discuss about seventh question. The enrollment in a school during 6 consecutive years was as follows. That is 1555 1670 1750 2013 2540 and 2820, right? Okay, this is also we need to find out here. Find the mean enrollment of the school for this period. Okay. And this one you do at home. Mean is equal to sum of all observations divided number of observations. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? Okay. Okay. Now, here we have 8th question. The rainfall in millimeter in a city of 7 days of a certain week was recorded as follows. Right? They have given here 8th question. First one, find the range of the rainfall in the above data. Find the mean rainfall for the week. And on how many days was the rainfall less than the mean rainfall they have told, right? Okay, we have to compare with the mean rainfall. Okay, find the range, you know, highest and lowest. Difference between highest and lowest. Okay. And second one, mean we need to find the given table here, Monday to Sunday, that is total how many days? 7 days, and also rainfall in mm, 0.0 and 12.2 on Tuesday, 2.1 on Wednesday, 0.0 is on Thursday, 20.5 on Friday, 5.5 on Saturday, 1.0 on Sunday. Okay, now let us see solution. Okay, seventh question is homework to you. Okay, solution eighth. Okay, first question, what is that range we need to find out, right? Range is equal to H minus L, which is an highest in this. Look out this question. Okay, which is an highest in this, that is 20.5 on Friday, right? 20.5. And which is an lowest in this, 0.0, that is you can take here Monday or Thursday, right? Both are equal. H minus L, that is 20.5 minus that is 0.0, which is equal to, we will get I think same only, right? That is 20.5 mm. This is range. Okay. Now, second question, what he has asked here, second question, in second one, that is, we need to find mean rainfall is equal to sum of rainfall recorded divided by number of days. How many days given? 7 days, right? Is equal to sum of rainfall recorded. What are those? Let us see. First, that is on Monday 0.0, on Tuesday 12.2, on Wednesday that is 2.1, again on Thursday that is 0.0, plus that is Friday 20.5, okay, 20.5, plus on Saturday that is 5.5, plus on Sunday is 1.0, divided by how many days are there? 7 days are there, right? How many days? 7 days. Therefore, mean is equal to, say, after adding, how much we will get here? 41.3 divided by 7. So it, after dividing, 7 1 ja 7, 7 6 ja, it will not come, 7 5 ja 35, right? Point I will take, and remaining how much here? Again, remaining here 7. Remaining 17, 41 minus 35, 11, that is 6, right? 63 we will get. 7 and how much? 63, right? Therefore, mean is 5.9. Therefore, mean is 5.9. Okay. 5.9. Okay, and third question, what he has asked here, third question is, on how many days was the rainfall less than the mean rainfall, they have told. Very simple here, I have taken your scores now. See, look at this. 0.0, 12.2, 2.1, 0.0, 20.5, 5.5. Here, 12.2 and 20.5. Okay, except those, and remaining we have to take here very less. 0.0, 2.1, 0.0, 5.5, 1.0. Is it? This is Monday, this is Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday and Sunday. Total how many days? 5 days. Okay, third question, 5 days. How many days here? 5 days. That is Monday, Wednesday and Thursday, Saturday, okay, and next Sunday, okay, and this is the right answer. Okay, and Sunday rainfalls less than the mean rainfall. Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about ninth question. The heights of 10 girls were measured in centimeter and the results are as follows. Okay, 135, 150, 139, 128, 151, 132, 146, 149, 143, 141, right? Okay, we need to find out here first question, what is the height of the tallest girl and what is the highest of the shortest girl, height of the it is, okay? What is the height of the shortest and what is the height of the tallest? Okay. Third question, what is the range of the data? Fourth question, what is the mean height of the girls? And fifth question, how many girls have heights more than the mean height? Okay. Let us see now solution. And also they have given here already the number of girls. How many are there here? 10 are there, right? Okay, dear students, what is the height of the tallest girl here? Look at those. 135, 150, 139, 128, 151. 150 only, one is 151 is there, right? And tallest girl, that is 151. And what is the height of the shortest girl? Second question is, what is that? Shortest girl height. Shortest girl height, that is, I think, 135, you know. Look this. So 128 is there, right? Okay, 151 is highest and 128 is the lowest. Okay, shortest girl, height of the shortest girl. Okay, first question over, second question over, and third question you see, what is the range? Highest minus lowest, 151 minus 128, you will get the answer for range. And fourth question, what is the mean height of the girl? That is sum of all observations, is it sum of height, right? Sum of height divided by number of girls. Okay, and after that, fifth one is how many girls have highest more than the mean height. Okay, I will write solution now. Solution, question number, that is 9. Okay, height of the tallest girl, height of H-E-I-G-H-T, height of tallest girl is equal to, how much is there? 151. Next, height of shortest girl, that is how much I told you? 128, right? Okay, this is the first one. Now, second one. Range we need. See, tallest, the highest minus lowest. Shortest means the lowest, right? Okay, range is equal to H minus L. Okay, that is highest is 151 and minus 128. So, what you will get answer here is equal to here 151 minus 128, 11 minus 8, that is 3 we will get. Okay, and remaining is 1, 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. Answer is, that is 23 centimeter, that is range. 23 centimeter, right? Okay, third question we have, that is the range. Okay, third question, what is that? See, this is only second question. First one, second one, this is, third one is range, and now we have fourth one, that is mean, right? Mean is equal to, what can we take here? Sum of heights of the girl. Sum of heights of the girl divided by, that is the number of girls. Number of girls, right? Is equal to, we should add all those, right? What are there here? 135 plus 150 plus 139 plus 128 plus 151 plus 132 plus 146 plus 149 plus and 143 plus 141 whole divided by number of girls. How many are there? 10 are there, right? How many are there? 10 are there. Therefore, mean is equal to, after adding all those heights of girls, which is equal to 1414, okay, divided by 10. You know addition, okay, you can do. And here, this one we will get, see, divided by 10 means, see here, 10th place. So, after 1 After one digit, we have to keep here decimal point. That's it. Okay, that is 141.4. Okay, 4 centimeter. Mean is equal to. Okay, mean is equal to 141.4 centimeter. Right? Now, what is the fourth question? How many girls have heights more than the mean height? Okay, how many girls? Let us see now. That is, in this only look out. Look out those heights. That is 150 is there. Okay, more they have told. Is right? 150. Next, 151. Next, 146 also is there. 149 also is there. 143 also is there, right? Okay, total how many are there? Let us see now. 5 girls. How many? 5 girls. That is fifth question. Answer is 5 girls. That is 150, 151, 146, 149. 1, 2, 3, 4. 149 plus, sorry, 143. Okay, 143 have heights in centimeter. Have heights in centimeter more than the mean weight. More than the mean weight. Okay, 5 girls, right, have heights in centimeter more than the mean height. This is the right answer.